Hello friends, in our organic chemistry name reaction section, today we are going to start a new name reaction, that is Suzuki coupling reaction. So we will study Suzuki coupling reaction in this video, and I will include some four other name reactions which are very much related to the Suzuki coupling reaction, and you can understand all the five reactions with very easy way, right? So we are going to start. Okay, let's start. So which four other another name reaction we will learn from the Suzuki? That is Hiyama coupling, Negishi coupling, Sonagashira coupling, and Stille coupling. So Suzuki coupling and other four coupling are mostly matching to each other, but only the difference is about the metals. Now what is the difference and how they are correlated, that you can grasp very easily. So first we will go to the Suzuki, its principle and reaction, and then we will see the difference between all the four, and you can easily memorize all the reaction for the preparations of different competitive exam interviews, etc. Right? So let's start. First we will see the principle of Suzuki reaction. What is the principle? It is very easy. You have to take a palladium catalyst possessing zero oxidation state. Right? In presence of palladium catalyst, you can react organic halides, say for example iodobenzene, etc. It may be heterocyclic also, it may be aromatic also, any of organic halide, if reacts with organoborane compound, right? You can also take, in place of organic halide, you can also take organic triflates also, right? So reaction of organic halide or triflate with organoborane compound in presence of palladium catalyst will form a new covalent bond between two different carbon, one from the organic halide or triflate and another from the organic borane, right? So two different carbon will join with a new CC bond, and this process can be done followed by base transmetallization process. How it's occurring, that we will see very easily in our reaction mechanism, right? So what is the basic concept, what is the basic principle of Suzuki coupling? That is nothing. You have to take any of organic halide or triflate, just react with organoboranes in presence of palladium catalyst, and you will get a new formation of CC bond between two different carbon among the molecules, right? So let's start reaction. You can see here any organic, R means you can take any of organic halide, it may be triflate also, right? And reacts with some borane derivative compound, right? Boronic derivative compound, right? And palladium is taken with zero oxidation state, and two ligands are already added to the palladium, right? And as a base catalyst, we took the sodium alkoxide. In by that way, what we are getting? We are getting a new formation of CC bond between these two carbon, R and R1. They will join with a covalent bond, new CC bond. This is a new CC bond formation between the two different molecule, right? And creates one new molecule. That will be your Suzuki coupling reaction. So this is all about the basic reaction, what happening in Suzuki, right? Now we will see other four name reaction are concerned with this Suzuki how, right? So first we will understand the Suzuki in very simplest way. What we have to take, as I told, RX, any of organic halide, right? Any of organic halide. Now I am commonly writing, see in our Suzuki reaction, we wrote B, boron metal with some organic molecule, right? So it's called organometallic compound. So commonly I am writing this reaction as R-M, M for metal, R for some organic part. So basically this compound is what? It is nothing but organometallic compound. And as we know, we have to use the palladium in the zero oxidation state, maybe with two ligands, but the oxidation state will be zero, right? So we will take RX, organic halide, reacts it with any of organometallic compound, but we cannot take any of organic metallic compound. Why? Because if you change the metal, the name reaction will definitely change. Name reaction will definitely change. And what will be the product? This and this will be the leaving groups. This and this will be the leaving groups. And a new formation of C-C bond between R and R' will take place. R and R' will take place, right? So now we will understand now which reaction, which metal, if we utilize, it's known as which reaction, right? So as I told in the earlier previous reaction, if you take R and boron, metal as boron, here M is taken as boron, right? So here I am writing R'. Why? Because I wrote here R'. So this will be same, organohalide will be same, but if you change the metal, if you take the boron, the reaction will be known as Suzuki. Coupling reaction. Suzuki coupling reaction. So organometallic compound if of boron, then the reaction will be known as Suzuki coupling reaction, right? I hope it is very clear to everyone. Same alkyl halide, or you can say not alkyl, but you can say organic halide, right? So same organic halide, but if you change the metal in the organometallic compound, metal in the organometallic compound, say for example, if we are using R', now metal will be silicon, metal will be silicon, right? So this reaction with silicon organometallic compound should known as Hiiyama coupling. Reaction, Hiiyama coupling reaction, right? Now suppose you are changing the metal, right? And you are writing a new metal, that is R' is as it is, right? You can take any of organic halide, but if you change the metal, if you take zinc, organometallic compound of zinc, then the reaction will be known as Negishi reaction. The reaction will be known as Negishi coupling reaction, right? So, as we seen, boron if taken as metal, then Suzuki coupling. If silicon is taken, then Hiiyama coupling. If zinc is taken, then Negishi coupling reaction, right? Now, suppose we are taking R' and metal as copper. Metal as copper, right? The reaction will be known as Sonogashira coupling reaction. Sonogashira coupling reaction, right? And now we are changing the metal. Say for example, we are taking a metal R', the organic compound metal will be tin, Sn, right? So the reaction will be known as Stille coupling reaction, right? So I hope it is very clear to everyone now. The same reaction, any of organic halide, if reacts with some organometallic compound in presence of palladium zero oxidation state, formation of a new C-C bond. Formation of a new C-C bond will known as Suzuki coupling if the metal is boron. If you take the silicon as metal, then Hiiyama coupling reaction. If you take the zinc metal, then Negishi coupling reaction. If you take copper as a metal for organometallic compounds, Sonogashira coupling reaction. And if metal is tin, Sn, right, then the reaction is known as Stille coupling reaction, right? I hope it is very clear to everyone right now. And we are moving to the next part, that is nothing but the mechanism part, right? As we seen, all the reactions are almost same. The difference is only in organometallic compounds, metals, and mechanism will be almost same. Mechanism will be almost same, right? In this video, particularly we are going with the mechanism of Suzuki coupling reaction, but rest of the mechanisms are little bit same, right? Only minor change will be there. That we'll also learn in some new video for each and every reaction, right? But if you appear for any competitive exam like NET, SET, GATE, etc., right? If you are preparing for JEE, etc., so at that time you must have basic knowledge about all the five reactions together, so you can identify actually which reaction is which one, right? Okay, so now we are going to see the mechanism part. Just we took the organic halide, any of organic halide, and we are reacting with first palladium catalyst in the zero oxidation state connected to two ligands, right? It is a simple like Grignard, the oxidative addition will take place. Oxidative addition will take place. So what we will get? In between R and X, we will get PD and two ligands connected to PD, right? Palladium. So it is called oxidative addition step. So first step in the mechanism of Suzuki reaction, that is oxidative addition reaction, right? So first step, whatever product we get for the first step, we are carry forwarding into the next step. You can see the next, our previous product is here, right? But it is going to react with some boronic acid derivative. Boronic acid derivative. Don't worry about R1, R2 and R3. Don't get so much tense, right? R1, R2 and R3 will be anything. Suppose, say for example, you are taking BOH twice in place of R2, you can take OH. And here, suppose in R1 is benzene, right? Say for example, R1 equal to benzene and boron is we shown upper side, right? Connected to R2 twice means OH twice, right? So you can take anything like that, right? And if you react this boronic acid derivative to the base, so what will happen in presence of base, addition of one OR minus will be, electron will be donated to the boron, and boron should possess negative charge. Right? So we will get formation of this intermediate, and that we will react with our product of step one, right? Now negative charge with boron, right? So now what happened? So you can see, we have already boron connected to R1, right? So boron connected to R1. So for the stability purpose, boron will get positive charge to get stabilized and donate electron to the R1, right? So now X will be removed. In place of X, we will get the R1, right? X will came out, and this process is known as transmetallization isomerization. Why? Because R1 previously connected to boron. Now it's going to connect with the palladium, right? So simply you can see the metal chain. So the reaction is known as transmetallization reaction, right? Now this is our the second step, and now we are further moving to the next step. This is nothing. You take your compound, reacts with another, what we removed here, that will react with, and we will get the reductive elimination of palladium with two ligand. Right? So what was the oxidation state? Just we are going behind. Why we call this reaction as oxidative addition? Because here the palladium oxidation state was zero. But if you see here, oxidation state is plus two. Right now, if you go ahead, the oxidation is plus two. But now, in case of here, you get the palladium again with the zero oxidation state. That's why the reaction is known as reductive, and elimination means removal of the palladium, removal of the palladium. Now, two are having free valency will make a covalent bond with each other. We bond with each other, and that will be mu CC bond, and that is about the Suzuki coupling reaction, right? So this is the basic mechanism how Suzuki works. Now we are moving to the next part. In some books, in some reference, you may see same reaction mechanism in cyclic way also. It shows the same thing. Just we are going fastly around that. You can see palladium is taken in zero oxidation state, reaction with organic halide, just give the oxidative addition as we seen in the previous mechanism. In presence of base, OH will be nucleophilic addition will be there, OH will come in place of X and removal of NX will be there. Then again, the boronic acid derivative reacts with our compound, right, organometallic compound, and further you can see the transmetallization process. The boron connected to Ar dash will come to the palladium, so metal chain. So this process is known as transmetallization process, and then reductive elimination will give you the mu CC bond Suzuki coupling reaction, that is Ar dash. So both of the mechanisms are same, no change into that, but the representations are only different, right? I hope you get my point. So don't worry about if you see any books or any reference and different presentation will never change the mechanism. It will show you the another ways only to show your same thing, right? Okay, next we are moving to the application parts of the Suzuki coupling reaction, right? So you can see the carbon of this benzene is denoted with red color, and this benzene's color is denoted by the C, blue color, right? So it's a boronic, here boron should be there, but due to some printing mistake, I forgot to, so I'm sorry for that. So boron is here, so it's a boronic acid derivative, and it will react with this one. Removal of these two leaving groups will be there, and you will get a new CC coupling. You will get a new CC coupling that is here. That is here, right? So I hope you get my point. This is the first application. Palladium taken in the zero oxidation state. Finally, first it will oxidize, get second plus two oxidation state, further get reduced, and finally come out as PD0, as we seen in the mechanism, right? So this is first application of Suzuki coupling reaction. Now next one we are going to see, just wait 1 second. Yeah. Second one, you can take a heterocyclic, organic means it may be heterocyclic also, right? So organic halide reacts with some boronic acid derivative. Actually, it is an organoborane compound, right? So as we've seen, that this part will be leaving group, this part will be leaving group, and it will connect to the carbon which is connected to halogen. So formation of a new CC bond, I am denoting by red color, you can see. Right, it is another example of Suzuki coupling reaction. Metal utilizes boron, so reaction is known as Suzuki coupling reaction. And you can take any of whatever, you can see furan, thiophene, thiazole, oxazole, etc. You can take any of them, right, as a heterocyclic aromatic compounds, right? And if it reacts with in place of organic halide, here the triflate is taken. As I told in the principle, you can take alkyl halide, aryl halide, or any of organic halide compound, or you can also take the aryl triflates also. In presence of palladium catalyst, it will give you a new CC bond. I am denoting by the red color, you can see, right? So this reaction is also known as Suzuki coupling reaction. Why? Because the metal utilizes and palladium, right? Not palladium, but whatever you here you are utilizing, that should be boron. That should be boron, right? PD is always common in all the reaction, as I told in the previous, right? So this is all about the Suzuki coupling reaction. The reaction is taken from the reference, Russian Chemical Society. Paper was Organic Biomolecule Chemistry, and this is the publication who done this work. Right? So this is taken from some reference for the application purpose. And I hope you get all the idea about all the five reactions, as I told Suzuki, Iyama, Negishi, Shonagashira, and Stille coupling, right? So this is all about the Suzuki coupling. Thank you very much for listening me patiently. We will meet in the next video. If you have any question, you can put in the comment box in YouTube. I will solve your queries. I will try to answer each and everything. And if you like the video, please like it. Thank you for listening.